In this video, we will show you how to hide or display elements on a page depending on whether certain conditions are met or not. We will use conditional rendering and explain how it's different to the standard CSS display property. We'll explain in what ways conditional rendering is more powerful and when to use the CSS property instead. In our design, we have a page where users can create a ticket and they can select whether it's a sales question, product feedback, or a bug. When they select the sales question, they only have 4 input fields. But when they want to provide product feedback or report a bug, there are a couple more fields. There is a checkbox to say if the ticket is needed soon or not, and there are inputs for project links, video links, and screenshots. And finally, if the user checks that this is needed soon checkbox, then this input appears to explain why the need is urgent. Now in WeWeb, we have our create ticket page with the 3 ticket types and all the input fields. What we'd like to do is hide the items that are not needed, do not need to be displayed when the user has selected a sales question. And then we'll want to display those elements when the user checks product feedback or bug, but only display this little urgency input box when they have checked this checkbox. There are 2 ways we could do this. We could use the standard CSS display property, or we could use conditional rendering. In both cases, whether we're using the CSS display property or conditional rendering, we will need to phrase a condition to tell the navigator what it needs to do, when it needs to display or render that element, and when it needs to hide it or not render it. A conditional statement expects a true or false answer. We have 3 checkboxes with false or true statements. So for this block, then this is needed soon, we could say we only want to display it if the bug checkbox or the product checkbox is true. In this case, it's false because both are false. If I go to preview mode and click on product feedback, this is now true. So the condition is now true and the element is now displayed on the page. Now let's go into preview mode and open the browser's inspector. If we inspect this is needed soon element, we see it in the source code inside our browser. And if I click on sales question, even though it disappears on the page, you can't see it here anymore, you can still see it in the source code. That's how the CSS display property works. It hides the element on the page, but the element is rendered in the source code that you find in your navigator. This is very different from conditional rendering. Let's go back to WeWeb, back to editing mode. And on our needed soon element, instead of a formula on the display, the CSS display property, we'll cut this formula, we'll unbind here, and we will paste the formula instead on the conditional rendering setting. So it's exactly the same condition. We're saying, you know, render the element if the bug checkbox or the product feedback checkbox is true. Now in preview mode, you see it behaves the same way on the page. So sales question, no checkbox, product feedback, it appears. Bug, it stays. Sales question, it disappears. All right, so again, let's open our browser's inspector. And here I will select the this is needed soon. So I see it here. It's right there. And if I click on bug, it stays here. But if I click on sales question, it disappears. It's disappeared completely from the source code. The element, the needed soon element, is no longer rendered in the browser. This is great because if you're working with a complex page that has a lot of elements, but you don't need to display them all at the same time, you can optimize the performance of your web browser. By using conditional rendering, you can decide when to render an element. Tell your browser, okay, now you render it, now you make an effort. But on page load, only render those elements, not all of them. This is different to the display property in CSS because with the CSS display property, if you have a lot of elements on the page, even if you don't display them all, they need to be loaded, they need to be rendered, all of them on page load. So in most cases, we would recommend using the conditional rendering setting instead of the CSS display property. The only exception is if you need to access a component variable, then you need to make sure that component, that element, is rendered in the browser, even if it's not displayed on the page.